Hey guys, this is Steve with TronicsFix, and today we're talking about the blue light of death on the PS4 game console. Now, the blue light of death, also known as the blinking blue light or pulsing blue light, has plagued every version of every PS4 console. So today I'm going to talk to you about what it is, what causes it, and how you might be able to fix yours. So first, let's start with the cause. When you first start up your game console, you press the button and it will blink the blue light for a few seconds, up to sometimes 30 seconds or a minute. What that is basically a self-check of the PlayStation 4 software and system. So it will go through a check and check all of its systems. If it finds everything to be fine, then it will turn on the white light and you'll start seeing the display on your TV. Now, for some game consoles, unfortunately, the blue light just continues to blink and it will just blink basically forever until you turn your game console off. And that is what is known as the blue light of death. So now that we know what it is, what causes it? Well, the cause of the blue light of death is one of several things. Most of the time, the vast majority of the time, it is a problem with the main chip on the motherboard. This is called the APU. It's a combination of GPU and CPU, all built into one chip called the APU. And this chip is held onto the motherboard with a whole bunch of little tiny solder connections. These are little tiny solder balls. And basically, to get the chip on or off, you need to heat it. This chip I just pried up from the motherboard just so you could see all the solder connections and then the little circuit traces that are connected to the chip. So I'm gonna zoom up on that just so you get an idea of what I'm talking about there, and you can see it up a little bit closer. So this is the APU chip right here. This chip I have removed from the motherboard so I can flip it up like this. You can see each one of these little connections down here is a circuit trace from the motherboard onto the chip. Each one of these little bumps you see here is an individual solder ball. And you can see there's corresponding pads down here. That's how this chip is held on with these solder connections. Now, one of the main problems that these chips have had is sometimes these connections, the joints between the chip and the motherboard on these little solder balls, sometimes those will crack or something like that. But a more common problem with these is these little pads right here will get some sort of corrosion on them, and that will cause a bad connection between the chip and the motherboard. Now, with that corrosion on there, there's no way for the motherboard and other components to communicate with some points on this chip. Therefore, when the PS4 runs its test, when you first start it up, it can't communicate correctly with everything that it needs to, so it'll just leave that blue light going and you'll get the blue light of death. Another thing I do want to mention is these RAM chips all along the edge here have been known to cause the blue light of death as well. So sometimes these solder connections on these can cause the exact same problem as with the APU. So that is the blue light of death and what causes it. Now let's talk about possible fixes. If you have the original PS4 game console, the 1001 series, you may be in luck, as sometimes you can fix it by adding little plastic nylon washers under the clamp. You just unscrew the clamp, put them under these screws right here, screw it back on, and sometimes that will actually fix the console because that puts extra pressure on this chip and pushes those solder joints back together, and then it will sometimes work. Now, sometimes this fix only lasts for a few days, sometimes it lasts for years, there's just no way to know. So take this fix with a grain of salt, knowing that this may not be a permanent fix for your game console. Now, for those of you who own the PS4 Slim or PS4 Pro, I don't have great news for you. Unfortunately, the clamp fix for these two consoles doesn't seem to work. At least I haven't gotten it to work very well. Maybe you can, I don't know. But unfortunately, it just doesn't seem to work for these game consoles. So really the only thing you're left with is what's called a reball. And that is where somebody would heat this chip up, they would remove it, they would then clean all the solder balls off of the motherboard and the chip, they'd put new solder balls on, and then they would heat it back onto the motherboard. Now, a reball will sometimes fix a console, but unfortunately, again, there's really no way to know how long that will last. Sometimes it lasts for a long time, sometimes it doesn't last as long. Also, keep in mind that the problem might not actually be the chip or the solder under the chip, as I explained earlier. It could be in one of the RAM chips or something else on the motherboard, so even a reball is not a guaranteed fix. If your game console is still under warranty, for sure, no question, send it back to Sony for the Blue Light of Death fix. My understanding is they will most likely just send you another console, so hopefully your information is all saved online, as your data may not be there when you get it back. Other than that, unfortunately, there's not really any other fix I can recommend. You can always try to find someone to reball it, but as I said, that's not a guaranteed fix either. So unfortunately, there's just no great fix for this problem. Unfortunately, the Blue Light of Death is one of those problems that has plagued the PS4 console from the beginning all the way up to the PS4 Pro. And it's one of the worst problems you can have, in my opinion, because a lot of times there's just no easy, good way to fix it. So I'm sorry to bring you the bad news. Hopefully this doesn't ruin your day, and hopefully you can still give this video a thumbs up.